Alright guys, Matt Jansen here, and I'm here at the Revive facility, and we're getting ready to train some back with Ivana, Brett, and Nick Walker's in the bathroom. So I'm looking forward to this workout. We had a good leg session yesterday. It's very rare that we get together like this, so I like to embrace it. So we're getting ready to have a good back workout, and yeah.
What are we doing today? Tell them.
We took a lot of pre-workout, as you can tell.
A lot. And Matt is 30 minutes behind, so.
Here we go.
Here we go.
I just want to work out.
We really just want to work out.
One of the things within Nick's off-season that we're really emphasizing is getting to fully open up his lats. So just even here, I just noticed like within a pullover motion, it's really a stretch emphasis exercise to get the most out of it. So if you're not getting your head through the hole that your arms are creating at the top of the movement, you're missing out on the benefit there, all right? So that's why I kind of pushed him down to really emphasize that stretch portion of the movement to get those lats open and then fire from that open position. So within some point of your training, you need to train from a fully stretched position. I'm not saying you have to do it on every single exercise, but the more you can put that muscle through a full range, which is the goal here, that's what we're gonna try to emphasize.
Yeah. Oh. I'm fighting with Come on. Lightweight. Good. Come on, come on. Throw it up. One more. Good. Ready? Try. No, I don't like it. I don't like it.
Come on.
doesn't hurt.
What?
And I hope that this side doesn't hurt.
Come on, what do you got? There we go. Yeah.
specifically on that one to get the back view of Brett, because his scapular retraction, basically bringing his shoulder blades together, is really, really good. That's the whole point of this movement for upper back. You want to get your scapula to retract as much as possible. Just to give you guys an example of a difference, on the first pull-down movement, we were actually trying to keep our scapula fixed and just pull elbow drive to contract the lat, okay? So you can't fully contract your lat. You can't fully shorten your lat, but you can fully shorten the scapula. So that's kind of the goal of this movement versus a lat pull-down type movement.
I want to mix it up.
something I feel is very, very important, and we're all displaying it, so I just want to point it out. When you're doing a cable seated row, a lot of people turn it into a leg drive, leg press exercise, okay? So it's important to keep your legs locked and really just use tucking elbow drive into the waist. And with Ivana especially, she's trap dominant. So I'm just kind of overemphasizing with her pulling through her pinky finger just to really engage the lat versus the traps here. Because when you're driving your elbow into your side, you should be lat focused. Elbow out more, should be more trap rhomboid focused. But again, it all starts with your base. So don't be using leg drive, knee bending movement while you're doing this exercise to get the most out of it for your back.
Yeah.
yesterday we did an update video basically where everybody's at in their off season. Brent and Nick are gonna go through some posing today after back, but it was great for me to be with these guys this weekend. Obviously the environment wasn't like 100% conducive to bodybuilding. We've been running a lot. Meals haven't been perfect, but it's good to just kind of be able to connect with them, see them in person, help where I can with training, and just encourage each other and work hard. So it's been an awesome weekend. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this footage. We're gonna get to see these freaks pose a little bit, and we'll finish it up with that, all right?
You look like you're gonna cry.
Like a what?
He's gonna cry.
You ever seen a Logan movie?
Yeah. I showed that to,
Elbows forward, elbows forward.
I know, I talked to her. I said, research that. I said, why don't you know? Good, man.
Yeah.